Amen. And this morning, I just want to, amen, just recap what the Holy Ghost has for us to do and say. Last week, is something about last week, I mean, Wednesday this week, I sense a resistance. There was a resistance to what the Lord was saying in his house. Amen. People of God, is something that we must know. There will be people that will continuously to rebel against what God wants. Amen. There's people going to fight you because they don't want you to grow. They don't want you to be blessed. They like things the way it was. Come on, somebody. Amen. You got to know the people in your life, because there's some people, the minute you start to move forward, there's some people going to resist against your forwardness. They're going to always tell you it was better before you start all of this. Come on, somebody. You have to know the resistance. You have to know when people resist against your success. You have to know when people resist against you when you want to do something God told you to do. Amen. When God give you instructions, when people resist, give a resistance against supporting you when you going forward to do what God wants you to do. Amen. People of God, we must know there is a resistance in this house. Amen. But God will not hold it to this house. Amen. As long as we don't, give in to the resistance. Come on, somebody. We got to continue to move forward, because this is the year of recovery. This is our year of recovery. This is our year for great breakthroughs, signs, and wonders. Amen. When they were going to war, when David was going to war, there was 200 men didn't want to go. Amen. 200 men didn't want to go. Amen. But nevertheless, they went with the what? Amen. They went with the other. They went with the other half. And they got the victory. Come on, somebody. Then when they got the goods, when they got the victory, then the other man who went to fight says, now we can't share our goods with them because they didn't go with us. Amen. Amen. But David's being the man of God that he is, you know, he says, man, let's share with them anyhow. Amen. This is their conscience is going to be dealing with them as they eat. Amen. Come on. You can't eat and you can't really rejoice if you didn't really fight with us. Amen.
Yes.
But nevertheless, amen, we're going to eat together anyhow. We all going to have the victory.
Amen.
Amen. People of God, there's going to be resistance. Amen. But you cannot allow your resistance to stop you from doing what God say. Amen. I want us to continue to compel. Amen. And continue to. Amen. To let people know it is better to obey.
Yes.
Amen. It's better to obey. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. This Friday we will be going down to the. We'll be going to dip on Friday. We'll meet here at 6:30. Come at 6:30.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. There's some people going to be going to work early that morning, so we don't let nobody out.
Amen.
Amen. Nobody is going to be left out.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
Now, if there be anybody that does not dip, it is on them.
Yes.
It wouldn't be on Pastor Flowers.
Amen.
It would not be on Seed of Faith.
Yes.
It would be totally on those that make a conscious decision not to make it.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. So for me and my house, amen. That's all I can say.
Amen. Amen.
For me and my house,
yes,
we will be here at 6:30. Amen.
Amen.
And the bus will leave here at 7:15 sharp.
Amen.
And we will be by the waters for 7:30 precisely.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
And we will be dipping. Amen.
Yes.
From the moment we hit the water.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
We will be dipping.
Yes.
And it will take us approximately about a half an hour. And we will be done by approximately.
Yes, Jesus.
8 a.m. Come on, somebody, give God a high clap.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes, and we would have done what the Lord said.
Yes, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Like Minister John says about the fish and the bread, it is a secondary thing. It's something that we're going to do for fellowship. Amen. So we still want to do the fish and the XYZ. But the dipping is a mandatory thing.
Amen.
That's where God, amen. Because it's going to, amen, God, amen, our deliverance. We don't know what God delivering us from.
Yes, yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes,
we don't know yes. what it is.
Yes, Lord.
We don't know what it is.
Amen, amen.
Do you, anybody in this room know that we had a warning. We had a warning about sea surge warning. Hmm. Or tidal. Amen. Or sea surge wow. warning. Anybody knows that? This week?
Uh-uh.
Okay. We had a warning. Okay. They say that we could have a sea surge.
Hmm,
amen. So, just be aware. That's why don't shut off.
Amen,
what's going
amen,
on around you?
Amen,
you gotta be aware because what's going on around you?
Amen.
Amen. You don't know. Amen. You don't know what God is doing.
Amen.
That's why people of God, when Noah was preaching, Noah was telling them to come and they are. Amen. They ever say this man building this boat? He's crazy. Something wrong with him. Something wrong with him. Something right with him. Amen. Amen. So, Bonino, Friday.
Amen.
Morning, 6:30.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not, hear me at this pulpit. I'm not feeling sad for anybody that have the same opportunity that every one of us have and refuse consciously not to obey God. Come on, somebody.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Not to obey God. Amen.
Amen.
Because you can't bring a lump of flesh under subjection to get up on time to be here at 6:30. Amen.
Amen.
You better tell that flesh, you got to drag it. You got to drag it. If you can leave it, you can leave it, but come. Amen.
Amen.
But if you can't leave it, drag it. Come on, somebody.
Amen. Amen.
Come on, look at your neighbor and say, if you can't leave your flesh, bring it. Drag it.
Amen.
Amen.
Drag it.
Make it obey the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Make it obey. God wants to save us. God wants to deliver us. Amen.
Yes, yes,
there's some things
yes.
that has been hanging over us. There's some things, just in case you don't know, there's some things in the spiritual realm that has been trailing you.
Amen.
And you keep wondering why, you keep having a recycle of some things that happening in your life. The minute you dip, do you know whatever was upon you cannot no longer remain?
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Yes, yes,
amen.
Yes, amen.
Amen. When Jesus cast the demons where they, out of the man and men and the pigs, you see where the pigs gone?
Water.
The pigs went in the water to get delivered.
Amen, amen.
The pigs. They say, no. Whatever is, the pigs say, whatever is me, got to go when I hit that water.
Amen, amen.
The pigs know that.
That's
come on, somebody.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen. Come on now.
Amen.
Let's not act giddy.
Amen, amen,
amen. Whatever was acting strange in us. And trying to put
amen,
make us
yes.
act like somebody else.
Amen.
When we dip in that water, it got to go.
Amen.
Come on, somebody, give God praise.
Yes. Holy Spirit, amen, amen.
Amen. For a short while, very quickly, be in the book of Matthews. Very quickly in the book of Matthews. Chapter 25. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Ghost. Amen. Matthew chapter 25. Now the Bible says in verse 21 says, then the kingdom of heaven is like unto 10 virgins which took their lamps and they went forth to meet the bridegroom. And the Bible says in the second verse it says, and 5 of them was wise and 5 of them were foolish. Amen.
Amen.
This is what we have in the church. We are a mixture of people in God's house. Amen.
Amen.
And they that were foolish took no oil in their lamps, and they that were wise took oil in their lamps. And the Bible says in verse 5, it says, this is a recap. It says, in verse 5, it says, while the bridegroom tarried, while the bridegroom didn't show up, while the bridegroom didn't show up, they slept and fell. And they stumbled and fell. I mean, they stumbled and slept. They slept. It's like all of us, we all slumber sometimes and we fall short. Amen. Sometimes we slumber.
Amen.
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 And it's so ironic, I hear the preacher preaching the same thing on the radio just the other day. Amen. About how some of us, we do slumber. Amen. But it says something very, very, very unique. And it says, but there was a cry made at midnight, and behold, the bridegroom coming. There was a cry made, the bridegroom come, God show up. It says, and behold, let's go to meet him. And those that and those virgins arose, every one of them arose, and they trimmed their lamp. And the five foolish said unto the wise, give us some oil for our lamps, for oil had went out. Yeah, amen?
Amen.
He said, but the wise answered and said, not so. Amen? Which give us another level of this message. Amen? Amen. You ought to tell somebody not so when it's time. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We're giving time, we're giving nice as much as amen.
Amen.
Yes, but there's a time when you got to say not so.
So.
Come on, look at your neighbor and say not so.
Not so.
Amen. 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 There's some people that will see, that would like to, amen, party along the way, and they like to, and they like to keep on, to keep the party going.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and there's some people that don't like to show up to prayer meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. To some people that don't like to show up to prayer meeting. Now, if you're not coming up, if you're not praying, I don't expect for you to see the reason why you need the dip. Come on, somebody. Because the less spiritual you are, the less you can understand the necessary to dip. Come on, somebody. Because you're going to find all excuses in the world why you should not dip. Come on, somebody. Amen. But listen here, you can't allow nobody that is not as spiritual inclined as you are. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Amen. You see, one thing we have to understand about prayer, prayer keeps us connected to God.
Amen, mm-hmm. Amen.
There are moments in our life when nobody says anything, does amen. But we just so connected with God, we just feel so confident. Come on, somebody.
Yes,
we got so much confidence in the God that we serve.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know your confidence doesn't come from anybody, but it comes from God himself? Sometimes you just home by yourself and nobody ever call you and tell you have a nice day. Come on, somebody, nobody text you and tell you have a nice day, but you just feel so confident of this God.
Mm-hmm.
This tells the level of relationship that you have with God. The more confidence you have, the less people telling it to you. It shows that there is a God in you. Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
You see, we have to understand something, amen. That your source, the source in whom you believe is greater than anyone, than the external of you, anyone that is outside of you. Come on, somebody. But my encouragement, come on, somebody. My encouragement comes from the Lord,
mm-hmm.
The maker of heaven and earth. Amen. But this is just a recap of last week. Amen. And when God was saying to people, if we can just get to the place, amen, because nothing is going to happen without an accountability. There's nothing is going to happen for you in a great way. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Because you trying to figure out why you still waiting for something that God has for you. But the reason why, amen, the reason why you are still waiting, come on, somebody.
Amen.
The reason why you are still waiting is because there is some instructions that God has given to you that you still not even carried them out yet.
Jesus.
Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing until this morning.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all ain't saying nothing until this morning, but it is the truth anyhow. Amen. You see, that's what it is again with confidence. When you know God tell you something.
Yes.
Amen. And people look at you like you know with a cock eye, and they trying to tell you, preacher, where you going with this again? Come on, somebody.
Mm. Yes.
But there is gonna come a time. We're gonna look in the scriptures and we're gonna see that why there are some things that was hanging up. Held up, amen. There's some things that God has given you that have held you back.
Amen.
Because you have not carried out simple instructions. God has given each and every one of us simple instructions.
Yeah.
I believe that seed of faith could have been where it should have been maybe 8 years ago. Yeah. But there's some things that Pastor Flowers might not have done that causes us have to restart all over again. Come on, something. Mm-hmm. You understand that, but it's a reality.
Jesus.
There are some things that we have to recap. Mm-hmm. There are some things, people of God, that you have to recap. There are some things that you, if you don't do what God tells you to do, you're going to keep on starting over. You know, there's a you can watch a videotape, but it has an auto revive.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. You know, that movie will keep on going back to the beginning, and it tells you take it off auto.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen, amen.
But this is our faith. And tell me you have done the
work.
Will.
Amen.
Until we have done the will.
Amen.
We cannot move from this level until we have done the will.
Amen.
God says, God promised in his word, he says that after the will.
Amen.
Come and tell somebody after the will.
After the will.
You see, God wants good pleasure. We acting like it's only us that want pleasure.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
We acted as though it's only us that want good pleasure. God wants good pleasure too.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
See, I drink some. My wife tells me every time she put water there. Knowing that this is our 19th year of Jesus in my backwards. 28 years. I got to start drinking the water when she put it to the pulpit.
That's right.
Amen, amen.
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 Amen. She ain't giving me 28 years. She ain't giving me nothing.
Amen, amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen, amen.
Come on, give God a praise. Amen. Check, you got to go over the pause the video, man. Amen. Amen. Everything raw deal. Jesus, Lord. Check, you got to pause this video sometimes. Amen. When you see me get off course, pause the video, please. Amen.
Okay.
Listen. Let's read from verse, the 14th verse. The 14th verse, what it says.
For the kingdom of heaven is as a man traveling.
For the kingdom of heaven is like what?
A man traveling into a far country.
For man traveling is like a man, it's like a man traveling in a far country. What it says?
Who called his own servants.
Who called his own servants. You see, this is something I want to outline to you people, God, because sometimes we act as though we develop some things that we, do you know, no man really invented anything?
Amen, amen.
They say the man who invented electricity, you know what invented electricity?
Amen. Who created?
Do you know that?
Amen.
Electricity was never invented. Electricity is something that man has discovered.
Amen.
Electricity is a natural source.
Amen.
It is something that man had discovered. And what man did, man had discovered the way to store the energy.
Amen.
Such as in batteries. Store it in batteries that it can be there for usage.
Amen.
But man has never discovered electricity. Amen?
Amen.
So here it is. There is a time when something that God has given to us is going to be called back into accountability.
Amen.
Whether it be your singing, whether it be your preaching, whether it be your talking, your writing, something you does, it's going to call it back into accountability.
Amen.
You're going to have to give account for it. Some of you intercessors.
Amen.
Whatever God gives you, and I'm going to show you from the scriptures, that whatever the ability God gives you, that is your greatness.
Amen.
Whatever the ability God gives you is your greatness. Amen.
Amen.
Let's read. Verse 15, go ahead, somebody.
And unto one he gave 5 talents.
And unto one he gave 5 talents.
To another 2.
To another 2.
And to another 1.
And to another 1.
To every man.
To every man.
According to his several abilities.
according to his several ability.
And straightway took his journey.
And straightway he took his journey. Why would he take a journey after he would give these talents up? Because the talent God give you, it is for you, it is something God give you to develop and cause you to have dominion.
Amen.
This is the reason why straight away he took his journey. Because God gave you talent. You know what? You know, the system has messed us up. The system makes us believe because we don't have the degree.
Amen.
We don't have any talents. Now, I am not against the school and the college and all those different stuff. I enhance those things because because there's some skills. There, these institutions teach us. And under great discipline. Under great discipline, we learn a lot of things. But you're not, but the ability that God gave you, the talent God gave you, it is from birth. That's why leaders is not created.
Amen.
Leaders are born.
Amen.
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 You don't just learn how to be a leader. Amen. Leaders are born. The Bible says, from the ways of a child, you know, to a child doings, you know this child, you know where this child is going to be. From things that children do from age 5, 4, 3, 2.
Amen.
And you will know exactly their ability. But I know this one's going to be good. This one's going to be X, Y, Z. I can tell each one of my children what they are capable of.
Amen.
I have two of my kids that are good writers.
Amen.
Two of them. Very good writing. Very good writers. One of them was up here this morning and talked about he had to get himself together and write an essay. But that's a natural ability that he has.
Amen.
Whether he believe it or not, my other daughter, Angel, she has a very good ability. She can sit down and she can write a poem and you can a short story and she... And you know, she is right, just do, she is natural.
Amen.
But these are talent, if you don't believe in them, they're going to be undeveloped. And they're going to be dormant.
Amen.
And they're going to not. Why are you trying to get recognized without your talent? It's going to be difficult.
Mm.
Because it's the talent that God give you is the grace.
Amen.
To take you where you need to go. And as long as you don't understand this, you're going to continue to try to get recognition in something else. And the ability God give you, you just overlooking it. It's right in the scriptures. Let's look
Amen.
At it.
Amen.
Let's look at what it says, verse 15, let's read it again. It says, unto one he gave to 5 talents and one to another he gave 2, and to another he gave several ability. And straight away he went on his journey. Verse 16 says, then he that had received the 5 went and traded with the same and made other 5 talents. He went and traded. He went and developed more. He went and he got more. He said, God always give us something to start with.
Amen.
The 5 went away with 5. Now, you would say, why is it that God gave, why would God give one 5 and give one 2? And give one? That don't sound like it's fair. That don't sound fair. But if you know how God is and the creativeness of God, the one who had 5 might not be as greatly influenced as the one who got the 1.
Amen, amen. That's true.
The one who got the 1 talent has such an awesome call in his life or her life. How had such an awesome call that they are so afraid of that one talent that they have that they went and hid it. So this is the reason why you will see God gives 5 and 2 and 1. A 5 talent is not as greatly impacted, but yet it is a great talent. That it is good to have several abilities.
Amen.
But the one who got the one had no confidence. Had no confidence in the thing that God has given. He had no confidence. Absolutely no confidence.
Amen, amen.
So let's read. Go ahead, 16. Someone read 16.
Then he that had received the 5 talents.
Then he that had to receive the what?
5 talents.
The 5 talents.
Went and traded with the same.
Uh-huh.
And made them other 5 talents.
And made them other 5. Read.
And likewise. He that had received 2. He also gave other 2.
He also gave other 2. It's amazing. The one even had the 2 men to get, you went and dwell by the 2. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
One who had 2. Read what it says.
But he that had received one.
Went and dig in the earth. Made his life. He went and hide himself. I ain't getting nothing, you know. You know, did you ever see anybody who's so intellectual, very intelligent? Very intelligent and you know they got great potentials. But they're pushing the trolley, taking license plate and pick up license plates off on the road and little things and they can find and they're pushing the trolley. Mm. And you speak with them, you found that they got so much knowledge.
Mm. Amen.
You wonder how something that happened. That happened when you hid what God gave you. You hide what God gave you. Because you hide what God gave you, then you will take the remnants of everything else.
Amen, amen.
Everything else, you know what? They don't want this, so I can pick this up. They don't want that, so I can tell them, I might make $2 from this. And they pick up all the trash. Because they hid themselves. And this is the reason why we get some hell on some of these jobs, because God don't want us to be comfortable in just being a servant in some of these institutions, but God wants us to get to the place of the level, or get to a level where we become so integrated in what he called us to be, that we will focus on who we are. That's why I keep saying to myself, study yourself. I keep saying to myself, study yourself, son. Once you get to know you.
Amen.
Do you know if you get to know you in a real way?
Amen.
You will have so much confidence of who you are. Amen. You become you will even become less angry.
Amen.
Because you know who you are. When you know you, you are in touch with you. You hear sound and you hear symbols and you hear things that are not even here reaching to the natural.
Amen.
Even with prophecy, and I'm learning this even as I go. The more I know me, the more I will be able to be gifted and have all the giftings and abilities to minister. Confidence is the greatest equipment we can ever use to execute any of the gifts.
Amen.
Without confidence, you cannot perform in no level.
Yeah.
Because you will always have this being inferior to others.
Amen.
And feel that you are less than others. Because your confidence level is low. The lower your confidence is, you will never be able to be gifted. You can never be able to sing. Do you ever meet someone who can sing but they don't feel like they sound good?
Jesus.
And they get the most beautiful voice.
Amen.
And they go, ooh, and they sound like a mermaid. They sound like angels. But they don't feel as though they sound good. It's because their confidence is very low. As long as your confidence is not the way it should be, you will never to be able to please your God and nobody else. You might hear God say to go, but you will never go because their confidence is not telling you the right things and you're not feeling good about yourself. And if you're not feeling good about yourself, you will never go. You will never go. You will never move. You will always worry about what they say and what they think. I don't feel as though they will never accept me. It doesn't matter if they accept you. People do never have to accept you. As long as you have that confidence, your confidence draws people to you. I remember the time I had when they had the television program. This lady came in and she met me in the park store and she said, "You're the guy I saw on TV." I said, "Yes, I am he." Said, "You speak on this topic called about the thoughts." She said, "At the beginning, I wasn't even into you. She said, I was not even into you. She said, "But I noticed something about you. You had this confidence about what you were saying that draw me that draw my attention.
Amen.
You just sound like you were so sure. You were so sure of what you were saying and doing that I was stuck and I stayed there. And I watch you and I listen."
Amen.
It's confidence, people of God. It's your confidence that will operate and activate the gifts, the abilities that God has given to you.
Amen, amen.
That's Lord. You listen to some people when they take the microphone. You give them to certain people, they chew the mic right up. If you don't take this mic from vagina, this mic will turn a fire, this mic will melt. That's confidence. That's when people operate in something that they are sure about.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Jesus.
And you have nothing else. You just don't have no other choice than to listen. That's what confidence does.
Confidence draws people to your agenda. Hello. This is we're talking about the talents that God gives. The talents. You get one when you get one two when you get one. Let's read verse 17.
"And likewise, he that have received two,
yes,
also gained other two.
Uh-huh.
But he that have received one went and
digged in the earth.
And hid his Lord's money.
He's digging it. Why would you hid something God gave you? And then you notice the difference now? It actually shows you money. It says money. That means that whatever God gave you is going to bring in money. Whatever God gave you, it is there. God gave you something to dominate.
Amen.
Whatever God gave you is going to cause you to have dominion in this earth.
Amen.
I will never be broke again in my life. Come on, somebody.
Amen. Speak it.
And the reason why I say I will never be broke, I'm not saying it boastfully. I'm saying this with confidence because I know what God gave me is going to take care of me for the rest of my life.
Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. 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 Amen.
You got to be careful what the devil tells you. The devil says, "You can't say that." Oh, you can't say that. No, the devil tells you, "You can't say that," because he wants to keep you in a poverty line to control you.
Yes. Yes.
Look at what the government tried to do to you. Hmm. Keep opportunities from you because they can control you. If they can keep you in the poverty line, if they can keep you in the welfare, come on somebody, they control you.
Yes.
But they cannot control you being self-independent. Because you will speak out on issues.
Amen.
And this was our Lord. God wants each and every one of his children to be to the place where you become self-independent. But yet you are a worshiper. And you know who God is. I hear the testimony of Sister Elman. Her testimony was, last year she was dependent. This year she's independent. Come on, somebody, give God a praise for that.
Yes, hallelujah.
The talent that God gave us. God gave us such great talents. God gave us these talents that we will dominate. And take dominion. Don't allow people to take what God gave us. And make us feel as though we should be living on welfare.
Amen.
Confidence. Let's talk about a little bit about what confidence will do for us. Because if we have confidence in who we are, and we get to know ourselves, people of God, and I encourage everybody in this room to get to know who you are.
Amen.
Sometimes people can make you feel as though you've been born to celebrate them. God did not create you just to celebrate somebody or to go to somebody else's celebration. Come on, somebody. Aren't you tired of going to somebody else's celebration? Now, I don't have a problem going to their celebration, but let's understand this. I come to your celebration and you come to mine.
Yes, amen.
And this is what God has. This is what God is saying to us concerning the talents. There's something in you to be celebrated. You see, there's something we got to be careful of, because there will be a moment when you will feel as though you are not worthy to be celebrated. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I mean, yes, that's a moment feeling. Just a moment feeling. It's good to feel that way for a moment. But if you can get alone for a second, look in the mirror at yourself and see. Just get one moment to yourself. Anybody that spend a lot of time to themselves should be great.
Amen.
You see, sometimes you may not understand why I spend a lot of time in the office while praise and worship going on. But I spend a lot of time in my office. I spend a lot of time not reading, not praying. I spend a lot of time. That's why, anyone notice a mirror in my office? Huh? I spend a lot of time in the mirror. And I minister to myself. I tell myself, now you're going to go here and you're going to do well. And you're going to speak what thus says the Lord.
Amen.
That's what it does in there. I get me together. This, what you see, this courage that I have didn't just arrive. This came because I tell it to come.
Amen.
I told myself the way I must act.
Amen.
I told myself to walk with confidence. I told myself that what you say, your source, your God has approved already.
Amen. Yes.
So whether or not you say amen or not, it's already been approved.
Amen. God's approval. Yes. God's approval.
You see, amen. People, God, this is what I'm saying. Once you discover that this is what God wants, this is what God expects of me. You see, the devil plays with our mind when we are trifling. Between two opinions.
Yes.
So when you are trifling between two opinions, you can't have confidence with both.
That's it.
You can only have confidence with one, either the devil or God.
Yes.
Either life or darkness. Either power or powerless.
Amen.
Thank you,
Either you be a leader or you will be a follower.
Amen.
You don't decide to lead after. Come on, somebody. There's leaders right among us right now that are great leaders. But what shows that they're great leaders? Because they are great followers.
Amen.
In other words, because you can see greatness in some people the way they serve.
Amen.
Just the way they serve. You have no other alternative than to let them lead. Woo, you understand that?
Amen.
Come on, somebody, give God praise.
Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
This will make people great. This will make balance work real great. He never allowed leaders to come in his midst and not allow them to lead.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
The more I see the gifts in you and the abilities in you, and I bring you out and let you lead, make me greater.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. I learned that. I learned that from Jesus. Come on, somebody. Give Jesus a praise in this house.
Hallelujah.
I learned that philosophy from Jesus. Jesus demonstrated that. Amen. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So here it is. Here it is. This is what the church must know right here. What verse 19 says?
After a long time.
After a long time.
The Lord of those servants cometh.
A lot of what?
The Lord of those servants cometh.
The Lord of those servants came, and what happened?
And reckoneth with them.
And what?
Reckoneth with them.
And reckon with them. And what it says? Go ahead. Read.
So he that had received 5 talents.
He that had received 5.
Talents came
and
bought the 5 talents.
And he bought the 5. You see, people, God, what people understand is this. You see, whatever God gives you, God knows what he gives you. There's a time gonna come. There's a time gonna come when you gotta when you meet with your maker.
Amen.
And you gotta give an account. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
And you can say, Lord, you know, I was in this job and the boss didn't like me, and this is the reason why I never made it. And you know, I got home and I was so depressed and I didn't want nothing to do with life no more. Let's hear what those scriptures say about that. Read.
And the Lord gave him 5 talents more.
Go, God, the Lord gave him 5 talents more.
His Lord said unto him.
His Lord said unto them.
Well done.
Thy good.
Thou good and faithful
servant. Uh-huh.
Thou hast been faithful over a few things.
You've been faithful over a few things.
I will make thee.
You see how promotion comes? Promotion comes when God gives you instructions, you carry out the instructions.
Amen.
You see, like I told you, there was resistance on Wednesday. That was supposed to deter me from God, and I was to be passive now. I was to come back to church being passive.
Jesus.
I don't say that to make God be like, no.
Mm-mm.
No, God is able to.
Amen.
It ain't nothing going to happen except God build a house.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
The neighbor and me.
Sometimes God gets rid of old things to bring in the what?
Yes. Amen.
Sometimes the people, the ones that we really love, God is having to cut them off.
Jesus.
Jesus demonstrated that. Mm-hmm. Come on. This at this time around, there's some stuff going to be cut off for some of us.
Amen.
There's some people we got to lose some people that fight against the natural word of this ministry. There's some people that holding this ministry back in the burden has to go. And what he said, well done, my good faithful servant. You've been faithful over these little 5 talents I give you. So you know what? I'm gonna do something else. I'm gonna give you charge over much greater.
Yeah.
You see, we gotta understand something.
Amen.
Everything that happened in your life is relevant. Do you know that?
Amen.
Your impatience, if you deal with impatience, mm-hmm. it's God is saying. Listen, God is saying that I want to deal with your patience.
Amen.
Before your promotion.
Yes.
So I'm going to line you up in this life that people that will deal with your patience.
Mm-hmm.
People that you will get angry quick with. Just to show you, and if you really watching and reading your life properly, you will see that it's your attitude and your patience that's causing you to miss the mark every time God wants to promote you. But you gotta dominate that so you can get you can't let them ever come in your life and interrupt what God is trying to do. I don't care what you, how bad you try to talk to me. You can call me, you can talk about my mama, I don't care. I'm going to bless you and look at you and say, God bless you. Because I know what God is trying to do. I know God is trying to get me to a place.
Yes, hallelujah. Amen.
When you have confidence in God, people don't upset you no more.
Mm-hmm.
People can't upset you no more. You can't go through the whole life, your whole life going through the same test, same test. And when I say, when did you get rid of this attitude test, man? You're so quick to get mad. The Bible says, fool, get mad. Quickly.
Amen.
If you get, if you raise, it's like a sports car. You know what I say, sports car get, they test your speed by how quick you can get to 60. And they're one of the fastest cars right now. It's like a Porsche. A Porsche can get from 0 to 80, like in 30 seconds.
Wow.
That's how fast a Porsche is.
Wow.
A BMW comes next. They can go from 0 to 60 in 30 seconds. Everything based on how quick you can get to a revolution. And in a few seconds. Some of us is like these. We can get on. You know, we can have a conversation and I say one twist thing and you angry and you hot angry.
How about God?
Faster than the fastest car.
Jesus.
So when you're angry, you know you don't hear nothing no more. You can't even hear God no more. You can't even hear the voice of God no more. You can't even hear people stand still. You can't even hear mature. You can't hear say nothing. You can't hear keep your mouth because you the angry. I got to say when I got to say and I got to let it out the way it is. I shut the kata. You're angry. Fastest car. You see, and this is what God wants. God don't want us to be that way. We are not to be that way because God is all what God is doing is just, you see, everything so relevant is that we just trying to, God is just trying to get us to the place where He can give us more. Come on, somebody, say more.
More. Yes, Lord.
You can imagine God giving us more without any tests. You can imagine if you didn't have to go through persecution. You know the two church go through persecution? Your persecution don't mean that you're going to be defeated. Your persecution don't mean that the devil can get the victory of you. Your persecution does not mean that you're going to be the least. Your persecution means that everything that you go through, somebody going to try to cross you up, but you're going to overcome them because you know your purpose. You know who you are, and you're going to bypass that. Come on. You're going to bypass. You're going to, and just like, look at it, understand. Can you really understand our persecution like this? Understand this. If you've been driving long enough, you understand something. When you see another car out of the lane, and coming in your lane, you don't charge anything up and say, you know you were the wrong lane, let me write you off one time. You don't say that. What you do? You back aside and let them go.
Amen.
That's what life is. Mm-hmm. Park aside and let them go.
Amen.
So now, because you park aside and you let them go, you're going to continue on your journey.
That's it.
And you're going to meet your destination.
Amen.
Come on, you ain't saying
Amen.
Nothing.
Hallelujah.
We get the enemy to control our destination.
Jesus.
Come on, somebody. As a driver, do you know how many accidents I could have been in one day?
Amen.
If I were not vigilant? Come on. Sometimes when the guy feels as though you stop and pick up two passes for them, he come in front of you. If once he gets in front of you, he do the same thing. He all second breaks in front of you.
Jesus.
This is how I feel when you did that. And what I do is, I sit in the back there and smile.
Amen.
It's okay, then he's getting even. But he's not going to get into my space.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen, amen, amen.
You look at life as this. And this is how God is teaching us and promoting us as we go. When we get over this, we get to the place where God wants us. Read the next verse. I'm done right now. Read it. Let's go quickly. What it says?
He that received two talents.
Listen to this.
Came and said,
Lord,
thou deliverest unto me two talents. talents.
Thou deliverest of me 2 talents.
Behold, I have gained 2 other talents.
Behold, I gained 2 more.
Beside that, The Lord said unto him, Well done.
You've been faithful, man.
Thou hast been faithful over few things.
You've been faithful over these few things.
I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord.
You know, I've been traveling in this marriage now for 28 years. 28 years was not easy. 28 years, me and my wife could have been separated at least 28 times. For each year we could have money. We could have been divorced. We could have been done. We could have been finished. 28 years. What I'm saying is this. You got to make up your mind. You got to make up your mind to go to what life of the church. As much mistakes that I would have committed, my wife could have cashed me in 100 times. She didn't. Now, what you think is going to be her reward? Huh? What do you think is going to be her reward? She was more the recipient of most cases. But the reward's got to be, I can show you something right here. Read the next verse. It says, no, it's read the verse, same verse again. It says, you are 2 talents. And because, the Lord said to him,
well done, good and faithful servant.
Well done, good and faithful servant. Now, hold on now. Whenever God says well done, he don't mean that you've been, they're all, you see, when God tell you that in the midst of your life, he's telling you for this, for the level, that stage now, you've been good. I can say to my wife at this stage, she been good.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
At this 28 year stage, you been good. Now, because you've been faithful, I'm going to do something great. This is what God is saying. I'm going to do something great in your life. I'm going to cause you to see some years that the kangaroo, the caterpillar, and the locust has eaten. The caterpillar, the locust, and these are the things that you go through. You see, the only reason, the only way you can get to the place of where God wants you, it has to be a good reason. It has to be a reason. It has to be some reward. You see, God is about rewards. Given a reward after an action.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
Given a reward after an action, after you have completed a task.
Amen.
This is how God, the God that we serve, comes up after and says,
amen.
When God says, you've been good and you've been faithful,
amen.
It was after a task.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
And people still don't understand why David said, I'd rather be a doorkeeper than God, house of God. I'd rather keep God door. I'd rather keep the door. Because why? David realized something. It was God that caused him to win the battle. It was God that gave him the throne.
Yes, amen, amen.
It was God that gave him this throne to sit on.
Amen, amen.
When you realize something, when you realize that God did something to you, you see, we often take from God, but we don't reward God back. David says, you know what? I'm going to keep the house of God. Come on.
Amen, amen.
We can look at the road right there in the back. There's David right now.
Amen.
Keep the house of God.
Amen.
Sitting in the back there. Great man of God. Sitting in the back there. Mm-hmm. Awesome man of God. Keeping the door. But David says, I'll keep that door. I'm going to keep that door. Because why? When I think of, like Sister say, And I think about what God has done for me.
Amen.
I don't care what. I just want to be a part.
Amen. Amen.
I will do something.
Yeah.
Amen. I just want to do something. When you got people in God's house don't care about doing nothing, that's still their greatness.
Jesus.
Come on, somebody.
Jesus.
That's why you see many people get old in their old age and they left for many, many to be desired.
Mm-hmm.
Because why? They trifled when the opportunity was at hand.
Mm-hmm.
They trifled when God put before them the simple things that they can't be faithful with.
Jesus. Amen.
Simple things. You can tell the great people. No way, no way. God tell me right now. God tell me right now and say, son, step down the church right now. Close the church. Close the church right now. You know, I will, you know, I will be asking the Lord where you want me to go. Wherever God want me to go, I'll go and I'll serve. I'll serve my way back up to where he was.
Amen, amen.
You see, this is, you see, you got to understand God is about rewards.
Amen.
God is about awarding you.
Amen.
God is about telling you, you've been faithful over this, you've been faithful over that, and this is the system that the church follow. You cannot be just a number, come on.
Amen.
Come on, look at yourself, I'm not just a number.
I'm not just a number.
I'm a partaker. Come on, somebody. Anybody partake with Jesus?
Yes, Jesus.
We are partakers together.
With Christ. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
That's what God calls for. We can effect this kingdom work. We can effect this work. We're going to make this work what it ought to be. We're going to be a part of this. And I must say, while we talk about that, this church came, I came to this church this morning. It was so beautiful. Who did this? I know Pastor Sharon yesterday, she started decorating. But when I came here this morning, there was an extra beauty added to it. Who brought the bombs? You brought the bombs? You see what I'm talking about? Come on, give sister. Come on, God. You see, this is what God is talking about. God is talking about having a creative ability. With the talent and the gift that God has given to you, and you make it at the full use. Full use. I'm making it happen. Would you like for one day you go home and you meet a brand new bedroom sitting in your house? Who would like that right now?
Sounds good.
And I would like that. I would love that. That means you like that? You like to go home, or that's his home. Would you like to go to your bank account and meet the money there that you need?
Amen, amen.
One day?
Amen.
Okay. Let me use that analogy. Let's use that analogy. Hang that to the doorpost of your mind. One day! I would just like to meet this thing. Let's walk into something and it's there.
Amen.
As simple as I walk in here this morning and this place was looking like, woo! That's just the same analogy. Now, if that's what you want, you gotta sow it.
Amen.
You gotta sow some unexpected miracles. How do you sow an unexpected miracle? You sow some unexpected things that your pastor is not expecting you to do. Your leader is not expecting you to do. Your church is not expecting you to do. That's how it is. It's a creative. It's you are creating an avenue for God to say, well done. Pastor didn't ask you that. You didn't call and ask if you could do that. You just did it. And that same focus, God says that the same measure, God says, the same measure shall be met again. The unexpected act that you did, you're going to receive an unexpected act again.
Yeah.
You're going to receive the same action again. It's going to come back around and meet you again. Anytime that you've done something unexpectedly and God didn't didn't even ask you, and you didn't even bother saying, let me pray and see if God approve. But you know that, you know it in the homes of your mind and your thoughts, that God expected something out of you, and you were